Since 1867, when this material was first made, and it was the time when people were depending on a new source, which is not available in nature, and it is plastic. As once it is considered as a boon, now slowly becoming a curse to the mankind. Let's know why it is becoming a curse to the mankind. Plastic is a material that is highly ductile and can be molded into any shape. And the key factor is that it is highly durable. And all these things add up and made it the king of the packing industries. As the coin has two sides, the negative side of the plastic is that one of its boon has now become curse. As it is highly durable, it does not degrade fast. Do you know that the first ever made plastic, which is most probably in 1867, may not be degraded till now, because it takes around 450 years to degrade one plastic bottle cup. Then what is plastic? By definition, plastic is typically an organic polymer with high molecular mass and often contains different substances. Plastic is a material that is artificially produced and it is not available in nature. Just imagine a situation. You are about to wake up from your bed and getting ready to your daily chores. Just think, how many plastic items do you encounter in this small span? I am damn sure that this number will amaze you. From the mobile you use to the toothbrush you brush when you wake up, everything is made of plastic. As most of the things we use is generally made of plastic, it is our primary duty to know how this plastic was made. Plastic was generally made with organic materials like cellulose, natural gas, coal, of course crude oil. I will explain how this plastic was made in four simple steps. First, it all begins with the extraction of crude oil. Crude oil is nothing but an unrefined oil which is found in seas and other places like oceans and all. This crude oil comes with thousands of impurities. Who likes impurities? So the step two will be the removal of these impurities. The crude oil will be distilled, and as the crude oil consists of many heavier components, these are converted into lighter components called fractions. And naphtha was one of the most important fractions as it is used to make the plastic. And the step 3 will be the extraction of ethylene from this naphtha. Ethylene will be the monomer of this long polymer. As I said earlier, the plastic was a polymer. Polymer is nothing, just a building if monomer is a brick. So the step 4 will be the conversion of this ethylene to thin strings. Now these strings are melted and converted into small tablets. Now these tablets are melted and will be molded into the shape which we like. There was problem with the most of the plastic that we use in our daily life, but it was little when it compared to the single-use plastic that we use, like wrappers and straws. See this image. Every vegetable was wrapped with a special cover. What is the use of it? If one buys it, they just remove it and throw it and use the vegetables in it. Then what is the use of wrapping every vegetable? As this plastic does not degrade fast, they end up in oceans. As they don't degrade, this plastic will be broken into small pieces called microplastics. These microplastics will be sized up to 1/2 inch or 1/5 of the inch, which is too small, so they were eaten by the most of the fish. And by the end, these fish are eaten by us. Even though if you are a vegetarian, it affects you. On an average, a good seafood eater eats more than 11,000 microplastic pieces every year. According to a UN report, there are more than 51 trillion microplastic pieces in our oceans. And a study by British American scientists proves that there are more than 90% of the birds, and mostly seabirds, are having indigested plastic in their stomach. And more than 1 lakh sea turtles are dying every year due to this plastic. Even before the plastic was invented or produced, people used it to go to their shops and buy their grocery with the things like metals and permanent baskets which can be used daily. But two things in our history hiked up the production of the plastic. They are World War II and Great Depression. After this, the plastic production was hiked up by 300% and made the plastic one of the necessary things of our daily life. Out of 8.3 billion tons of plastic produced, 6.3 billion tons of plastic is going into waste, and we can't imagine our life without plastic. But let's make a promise that every plastic piece we use should go into recycle bin, as it is a time to change, because most of our lakes and rivers are getting cleaner due to this pandemic. Let's keep them safe and clean from now, so that we can give the same to our future generations. From now, let's say no to the single-use plastic, and let's begin smaller steps which bring a bigger impact in our environment. From next time, when we go to a grocery shop, let's carry our own bag, which makes a smaller difference, but it is a huge impact on our environment. So, let's together become the heroes of this planet, because according to me, a hero is one who saves the planet every time with smaller things. Please do share this video with all your lovable ones and make them as knowledgeable as you, and make them heroes together. And by the end, if you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe. Don't forget to hit that bell notification so that you will never miss an update from our channel. And by the end, bye Captain.